PeopleSoft Time and Labor now includes two Payable Time analytic dashboards. The Payable Time Insight dashboard contains visualizations for timekeepers and administrators. The Payable Time Trend dashboard enables management to see if there are any trends that may be of concern. Let's look at the Payable Time Insight dashboard first. The top section contains filters that can change from dashboard to dashboard, but are always related to the information contained on the dashboard. In this case, the filters relate to time and labor data, such as time reporter group and payable status. You can use the date filter to select specific time periods, for example, the current pay period. Use the quick select to use predefined periods, such as the last 30 days or last 2 years. Or use absolute, relative, or the current date. The Needs Review section contains visualizations for timekeepers or administrators. The four boxes display the hours that are in Approved, Needs Approval, Denied, and Rejected Payroll status. Where you are in the payroll cycle and how big these numbers are can indicate an issue. For example, if the payroll cycle has started and there are a lot of hours in the Approved status box, the time may not have been pulled from time and labor into payroll. The Quick Links section contains links that can be helpful, such as accessing pending approvals. The Payable Time by Status visualization shows the number of hours for each status, not just those that might indicate a problem. The Payable Status by Department shows which departments have hours in each payable status. This can highlight a department that has a lot of time that needs to be approved, or a department that denies a lot of time. The Exceptions and Exception Details visualizations work together to show the number and severity of the exceptions. Use the Go to Exception link to view more information and fix the exception. The Time Distribution section shows the calculated results in payable time. The Time Reporting Code, or TRC, category drill-down shows the calculated hours and estimated gross by TRC category. It also shows the hours that aren't assigned to a TRC category. Use the category to filter the information on the dashboard. For example, filter on the Premium Time category to see which TRCs are part of that category. Let's remove a filter and look at the Payable Time by TRC category visualization. This visualization is a double donut. The inside ring shows the TRC category. The outside ring shows the TRCs that are in that category. The Work versus Non-Work visualization shows the proportion of work hours and non-work hours. The visualization uses the non-work TRC and the work TRC value lists to determine how to categorize a TRC. The Payable Time Details visualization shows detailed information about the filtered data. Use the Detail link to access the Payable Time page. Now, let's look at the Payable Time Trend dashboard. Payable Time Trend by Department shows how many total hours are being paid by department over the last year. If payable hours suddenly jump or dip, this visualization alerts management that there may be issues with departmental staffing levels. The Payable Time Average Overtime Cost visualization shows the average cost of overtime by department over the last year. Management can quickly see which departments are averaging more overtime. This may lead to an adjustment in staff levels so that the department isn't paying a premium for the time worked. The Payable Time Insight and the Payable Time Trend dashboards use the new Payable Time Search and Payable Time Exceptions indexes. These indexes use real-time indexing. Both the Payable Time Insights and Payable Time Trend dashboards help your organization to manage your time and labor processes, as well as the overall staff. Access these resources for more information on real-time indexing. For more information, go to peoplesoftinfo.com.